Izmir, located in the west of Turkey, is the country's third largest city, and with its location at the Aegean Sea, it also has the second most important port. Even with its many parks and historic center, the city itself is not a popular tourist destination, but the countless tourist resorts around it supply it with a steady stream of visitors on a day trip. On the other side of the bay lies Cigli, not only a metropolitan district of Izmir, but also home to the Turkish Air Force's jet training base, equipped with T-37 and T-38. It was at this base that on June 4 and 5th, the Turkish Air Force celebrated its centenary, one of the main European air shows of 2011, attended by over 250,000 spectators, under the motto, "Aviators from all over the world meeting in Izmir." The airshow at Izmir-Cigli was a rare opportunity for the Turkish Air Force to present its hardware to the masses. Things like this UH-1 helicopter, for instance, are rarely if ever seen at foreign air shows. On the ground, many people took the opportunity to get close to the aircraft in the static park, where just about everything in the Turkish inventory was put on display. There were also plenty of foreign star items in the static, with Antonov 26s, a Bulgarian C-27 Spartan, and quite a few foreign fighters, like this RAF Tornado with bombing markings, Jordanian F-16s, a rare foreign appearance of a Bulgarian MiG-29, and the brand new JF-17 Thunder from Pakistan. But it was, of course, the Turkish Air Force people came to see, and there was plenty of it. Near the main entrance, visitors could find a collection of Turkish trainers, such as this KT-1T, which is due to replace the T-37s in the near future, T-38 Talons, and, of course, T-37 Tweeties, T-41 Mescalero, TB-20 Trinidad, and Marchetti SF-260. Plenty of military helicopters too, like this Cougar, this wonderful Cobra, a UH-1H, a Seahawk, and the Search and Rescue Iroquois. No lack of transports either, with this Casa 235 and the C-130. The latest addition to the inventory is this Peace Eagle, an early warning version of the famous Boeing 737 airliner. And more future plans, such as this Anka uninhabited aerial vehicle, the Cock Turk, and Turkey's future transport aircraft, the A400. Turkey's future fighter was there in mock-up form, the F-35 Joint Strike Fighter, together with the current fighter fleet. Watching them on the ground is watching the Turkish aircraft in the air, of course. The display kicked off with a parachute jump by rescue divers, some of them with flags.
Heading down to the ground, the purple smoke.
Here, the centenary flag, the Air Force flag, a picture of the father of modern Turkey, Kemal Atatürk, and of course the Turkish flag itself. After the jump aircraft lands at the nearby secondary airbase and the parachute is stored safely down, it was time for one of the highlights of the show, the Turkish Air Force inventory flypast, starting off with three Cougar medium transport helicopters. The following aircraft were trainers, starting with the T-41, Marchetti SF-260, the Korean-built KT-1T, T-37 and T-38. Transport aircraft are up next with this Kaza 235. C-160 and C-130, both in the colors of the Turkish stars. And the KC-135 air-to-air refueler. Finally, it was the turn of the fighters, with F-16s, F-4 Phantoms, and F-5 Freedom Fighters. The first proper display came from a historic aircraft, the T-34 Mentor, which the Turkish Air Force used from 1956 until 1993. This particular aircraft is now based at Kayseri Erkilet, having been replaced by the Marketti.
Nostaljik uçaklarından bir tanesi. Binbaşı Mojan komutasında.
Eğri. Bak Fethiye oldu sayından eğri. Kartalı gölgesi yürüdür bu vatan.
Always good for a few awes is Ali Oster in his modified Pitts S2, nicknamed Purple Violet. Ali is a regular visitor at Western air shows, but really outdid himself for a home crowd with plenty of negative maneuvers and very low level flybys. Addition to the European airshow scene is Solo Turk, the Turkish Air Force's F-16 solo display, flown by Major Murat Keles. He is the commander of the 141st Squadron, based at Ankara, and was helped to prepare his demonstration by the Royal Netherlands Air Force's F-16 solo demonstration team.
Aslanımız evladımız!
istediğiniz böyle gösterilir. Öyle 1.5-2G ile değil.
Şu da öyle.
Haydi size bakıyor, siz ona bakıyorsunuz, yine eksi G ile tırmanıyor. İnsanlar fena haldeler yerde. İnsanlar diyorlar ki, gökyüzünde o altın Türk bayrağı. Gönder onları, gönder, gönder yıldızları.
Of course, the main Turkish Air Force ambassadors were the highlight for the home crowd, the handsome pilots of the Turkish Stars from Konya with their 8 NF5 Freedom Fighters.
Bugüne kadar birçok yurt içi ve yurt dışı gösteride adından sıkça söz edilen yıldızlarımız bu anlamlı günde.
Thank you.
Sevgili İzmirliler, solo Türk diyorum, başka bir şey demiyorum ya da demek istemiyorum.
Plenty of foreign air forces joined the show. The first one we'll look at is the Austrian Air Force, which sent this Saab 105 in a striking color scheme. Because in fact, its unit, the Austrian Düsentrainerstaffel, or Jet Training Squadron, is an honorary member of the NATO Tiger Association. All of the unit's aircraft are based at Linz.
Tiger, Tiger, Tiger! Ediyoruz Avusturya'dan. Ellerine sağlık. Evet efendim. Thunderbird zamanı.
Another special color scheme. This one, the insignia of the Spanish Patrulla Aguila on one of the team's Casa 101 jet trainers. The Spanish-built Casa 101 is severely underpowered, which doesn't make flying aerobatics in close formation any easier, but the pilots always give it their best shot. Their show contains quite a few interesting maneuvers, such as a tail slide and the completely negative looping by the solo, the aircraft wearing the special tail marking incidentally.
Bravo.
and thanks to the nice stable weather, the team could perform its trademark formation landing. There were no fewer than 4 F-16 solo displays at Izmir, and here's the second one, coming from the Royal Netherlands Air Force, performed by Captain Tobias Schutte from 323 Squadron, based at Leeuwarden. During his show, Captain Schutte fires off several flares for extra effect. Like the Spanish team, the Polish Bielo-Czerwone Iskry team, or Red and White Sparks, also fly underpowered aircraft, the Polish TS-11 Trainer, and they remain quite high and distant for much of their display. Another jet trainer, this one a Romanian product, the Romanian IAR-99 SOIM, which means hawk. Development of this aircraft started back in 1975, with the first flight taking place in 1985. It entered service with the Romanian Air Force in 1989 and has undergone a major upgrade during the 1990s, when access to Western technology allowed the aircraft to become far more capable. It can be armed with bombs, rocket launchers or short-range air-to-air missiles, and with its upgraded avionics is an ideal aircraft for pilots which will progress to the MiG-21 or F-16.
Numerous missiles as well, including the OR-550 Magic that will...
Yüksek süratten düşük süret arasındaki bir manevra kabiliyeti izlettiriyor bize. Bravo. Bir de konu. Hiç de fena değil.
Şöyle dağlar tarafına bakalım, kontrol tarafına. yardımımıza verdiği katkıların dolayı Romanya Hava Kuvvetleri'nin IR-99'una çok teşekkür ederiz. Sırada ne var biliyor musunuz? Hemen şöyle dağlar tarafına bakalım, dağlar tarafına. Kırmızı kırmızı uçaklar görüyorum.
Great favorites wherever they appear are this team, the Croatian Krila Oluje, Wings of Storm. Storm being the name for the Croatian police and military. Unlike other teams, we'll see later on in this report, the team members of Krila Oluje are not full-time display pilots, but are flight instructors at the flight academy at Zimonek, tasked with training future Croatian Air Force pilots.
They will change formation one more time from plus 6 to delta 6 at the top of the loop.
The team aims to show the discipline, skill, precision and professionalism of Croatian pilots at air shows both at home and abroad. And they really do give an impressive demonstration with some maneuvers which only very few teams perform, and one that is unique to Krila Oluje. The team started in 2004 with four Swiss-built PC-9M training aircraft, increasing to 5 planes at the end of 2005. From 2005 until 2007, Krila Oluje became only the third aerobatic team in the world to have a female team member, Diana Dobos. Since 2009, the team flying their current number of 6 display aircraft.
After formation break, they will proceed with a beautiful heart-shaped maneuver and very attractive crossover in front of you.
Here the team approach in Rocket 6 and perform the Miro break, named after their first leader, before returning for a 3x3 cross in front of the public.
Team members since 2005, total amount of 1200
points. And they make it even more difficult with this 3x3 barrel roll cross. Here a maneuver only Krila Oluje perform, a tail sliding close formation. They are led by Major Damir Barezic, who joined the team in 2004 and has over 1500 flying hours. Here, number 6, Captain Christo, performs a double 4-point roll. Another rare maneuver, a stall turn in close formation.
This amazing maneuver is performed by only few display teams in the whole world. For next maneuver, 90 degrees turn loop.
90 derece dönüşlü bir loop izliyoruz sol tarafımızda. Fırtınanın kanatları.
Following this loop, during which they change in Diamond 4 formation, they perform a fast barrel roll at show center.
Tekrar elmas pozisyonunu aldılar efendim.
Right away they are proceeding to fast barrel roll in front of you.
Hemen bir hızlı fıçı tonoyla dar gelecek.
Here, numbers 4 and 5, Major Hasnek and Captain Verduka perform a close mirror flight.
Just few feet away from each other.
Evet, oklar! Fırtınanın kanatları o pozisyonunda.
As they're going away, you can see from the left...
As the main formation repositions to the left of the crowd in Diamond 4, numbers 4 and 5 perform a mirror turn. When the formation returns, they do so by pushing out of the looping and flying by an inverted diamond formation. Quite amazing.
Ladies and Ladies and gentlemen, inverted diamond four formation by Krill Arue.
Lütfen bakar mısınız? Sanki düz ve normal içiyorlar. Dördü yeterse bravo. Adetin spinini dönüşünü. Evet. Evet. Uçak kontrolden çıkmış gibi görünüyor burada. Ama onlar akrobasi pilotu. Vardır bir sürprizi. Evet. Dört. Doğru. Dört. Dört adet viril yaptı ve önümüze doğru geliyor. Ve bu işte hani diyor alkış.
After recovering from the spin, Sol is turning left because on the right hand side.
Another new maneuver for 2011, a synchronized aileron roll by numbers 125. Returning in Delta 5, the main formation performs this inverted formation the team call Arena. And one of the team's final flybys is this one, with all six aircraft performing a triple mirror. There are only two teams in the entire world to perform this maneuver. Krila Uluye calls it DIA.
Congratulations, my friend.
Gap between air formations is just 2 meters or less.
2 metreden daha düşük bir mesafe var aralarında. İnanılmaz bir hareketti bu. Bravo. Haydi finalde önce onlara bir destek. Alkışlarınızla. Kıyla Uluğe. Haydi günün ilk finaline hazır mıyız? Kameralar bravo.
Another outstanding demonstration by the team. Third of the four F-16 displays, this is Commandant Mitch Berlin of the Belgian Air Force, flying in his Vortex. Mitch is in his third and final season as Belgian Air Force F-16 solo demonstration pilot and, as you can see, also knows where the flare drop button is located. A few months before the show, 349 Squadron, of which Commandant Berlin is part, was the first Belgian squadron to take part in air raids over Libya. During the slow speed pass, the additional Belgian Air Force markings are clearly visible on the display aircraft. And unlike the Turkish and Dutch F-16, the Belgian aircraft does not use a braking parachute to stop after landing. the pride of the French Air Force then, the Patrouille de France, led in 2011 by Cédric Tranchon, a former Mirage 2000 pilot from Cambrai. They opened their display in Turkey with the Turkish colors rather than the French ones in the sky, obviously to the delight of the crowd. And they continue to impress the audience with their highly polished routine. Equally spectacular was this C-27 Spartan of the Italian Air Force's test center at Pratica di Mare, doing things transport aircraft really oughtn't try. Like this.
150 knots, 3 G's to the maximum performance and...
Or that. Yes, that is a loop. Here, a knife edge. Very difficult to fly with such a large aircraft.
Pozisyonunda, kargo kapağı da açık. Buradan bilir mi diyorsunuz?
en başında bahsettiğim kameralar hazır olsun. Dalışına bakın. İnecek oradan, inecek. İnanılmaz bir şey. Bakın. Normal iniş modelini hatırlıyorsunuz diğer uçakların. Nerede?
Bakar mısınız ne oluyor?
End-to-end, a maximum performance landing.
Aman Allah'ım! Böyle iniş gördünüz mü ömrünüzde? Ben bunu buradan alkışlıyorum, bravo! Bravo, şey 27 Luca! Ne yaptık kardeşim?
And there was more to come from the Italian Air Force, with this AMX strike aircraft, also from the Pratica di Mare test center. Here, you can clearly see the hard points where air-to-ground and air-to-air weapons are carried on this joint Italian-Brazilian project.
Kabiliyetli bir arkadaşımız, Amerikan Hava Kuvvetleri Test Pilotlu Okulu'na davet edilmiş kendisi. Belli zaten. Son derece yetenekli bir kardeşimiz oldu İtalya'dan.
This was the slow flight, 110 knots, 20 degrees alpha for the AMX.
Captain Orhan is now going to leave us as he goes to join the American Air Force again. Ask him about the pension rights this time when you get down there, Orhan.
Also from Italy, but from Rivolto this time, the Italian national aerobatic team Frecce Tricolori with their 10 MB339 jet trainers, seen here drawing the biggest Italian flag in the world against the Turkish sky. Quickly followed by their first split and cross.
Ready for the photo. 3, 2, 1.
Coming in the center now. Set. Go.
Go.
dünyanın en büyük İtalyan bayrağı Luciano Pavarotti'nin sesiyle beraber.
Italians couldn't get enough. Here's their latest combat aircraft, the Eurofighter Typhoon, once again displayed by their test unit from Pratica di Mare, showing the agility and power of the aircraft in a performance during which it hardly seems to leave afterburner. Flying the British flag in the Turkish sky were the Red Arrows, led by squadron leader Ben Murphy, and with a spiced up crowd rear arrival. Here, the team can be seen rolling in the sky during the Apollo Twister. The new maneuver for 2011 up next, the whirlwind.
Rolling
now. Hey, brother.
And back to their classic Diamond 9, before splitting up to commence the dynamic second half of their display.
Hoppa! Aşağıdan ikili geliyor, dikkat! Haydi kırgınlar, süzülüyor! Gökyüzünü de kaçırmayın!
This includes the popular crossing maneuvers by the synchro pair, Flight Lieutenants Dave Montenegro and Ben Plank. Here, the team perform their well-known rollbacks, with the pilots pulling the stick as hard as they can during the roll. The final synchro crossing and the Vixen break conclude the 2011 display by the Red Arrows. Now we saw the JF-17 Thunder in the static park at the beginning of this report. Here it is, performing in the air. It is a joint Pakistani-Chinese lightweight fighter. Development started back in 1999 and the Chinese prototype first flew in 2003, while a Pakistani prototype, with a slightly modified design, first took to the sky in 2006. It can be armed with over 3 tons of air-to-air and air-to-ground weapons, the latter both guided and unguided. The aircraft entered service with the Pakistani Air Force in 2010, with the Black Spider Squadron, which this aircraft belongs to. Pakistan currently has 150 JF-17s on order, with a possible increase to 250. It is also being considered by the air forces of Egypt, Azerbaijan, Sudan, Zimbabwe, Iran, Bangladesh, and Nigeria. Exports may be helped if the ongoing negotiations with European avionics manufacturers are successful. In China, the aircraft is designated FC-1 and is still under evaluation to assess its usefulness to the Air Force. And there was more to come from the Pakistani Air Force. What a treat to see them perform at the European Air Show. The Pakistani Air Force has over 65,000 personnel, about 3,000 of which are pilots, and they have a very diverse arsenal, which includes 40 of these F-16A MLU Block 15s. These aircraft are currently undergoing an upgrade in Turkey, so really this particular aircraft didn't have to travel all that far to perform at the show, but it was still a delight to see all the same, even more so because its display was very tight.
Exactly how much air that engine needs, and watch the back, watch the elevators at the back moving as the computer decides to keep that nose just at the right angle.
We finished this report with, what else, F-16s. Six of them in formation this time. This is the United States Air Force Demonstration Squadron, better known as the Thunderbirds. They take off with a formation of four, followed by the two solo aircraft. formation and solo maneuvers alternate throughout most of the show, so sit back and enjoy this performance.
We'll be right back.
And so we come to the end of our look at the Izmir Airshow 2011, celebrating 100 years of the Turkish Air Force in often dusty conditions and sometimes with annoyingly loud music on the showground, but still a more than worthwhile experience.